Are you serious? Are you serious? Man, I'll tell you, this is some great coffee. I hope you're doing great this morning. And I want to encourage you in your prayer life. Matter of fact, did you know the scripture said in Philippians 4, 6 and 7, be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be known unto God. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. In Matthew chapter 18, verses 18 and 19, it says, verily I say unto you, whatsoever you shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever you shall loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. And again I say unto you, that if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything that they shall ask, it shall be done for them of my Father, which is in heaven. The Bible also says, let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. That is Hebrews 4:16. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. That's Hebrews 11, verse 6. Confess your faults one for another, and pray one for another, and that you may be healed. The effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. Elias was a man subject to like passions as we are, and he prayed earnestly that it might not rain. And it rained not on the earth by the space of 3 years and 6 months. And he prayed again, and the heaven gave rain. The earth brought forth her fruit. That was James chapter 5, verses 16 through 18. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day. And having done all to stand, stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace, and above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith you shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked, and take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. That's Ephesians chapter 6, 13 through 18. And I say unto you, ask, and it shall be given you. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. That's a great promise in St. Luke's Gospel, chapter 11, verse 19. And when thou prayest, thou shalt not be as the hypocrites are. Because they love to pray standing in the synagogues and in the corners of the streets, that they may be seen of men. Verily I say unto you, they have their reward. But thou, when thou prayest, enter into thy closet. And when thou hast shut thy door, pray to the Father, and which is in secret. And thy Father, which seeth in secret, shall reward thee openly. That's Matthew chapter 6, 5 and 6. And he spake a parable unto them to this end, that men ought always to pray and not to faint. That's Luke 18, verse 1. For the eyes of the Lord are over the righteous, and his ears are attended open unto their prayers. But his face is turned of the face of the Lord is against them that do evil. That's 1 Peter 3:12. Evening and morning and noon will I pray and cry aloud, and he shall hear my voice. David said that in Psalms chapter 55, verse 17. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and make a joyful noise unto him with psalms. That's Psalms 95, 2. I cried unto the Lord and with my voice unto the Lord did I make my supplication. I poured out my complaint before him. I showed before him my trouble. Psalms 142, verses 1 and 2. And this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he heareth us. And if we know that he hears us, whatsoever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we desire of him. That's 1 John 5, verses 14 through 15. Thou shalt make thy prayer unto him, and he shall hear thee, and thou shalt pay thy vows. Thou shalt also decree a thing, and it shall be established unto thee, and the light shall shine upon thy ways. Job, chapter 22, verses 27 and 28. Likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities. For we know not what we should pray for as we ought, but the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. That's in Romans chapter 8, verse 26. My voice shalt thou hear in the morning. O Lord, in the morning will I direct my prayer unto thee, and will look up. Psalms 5, verse 3. But know that the Lord has set apart him that is godly for himself, and the Lord will hear when I call unto him. Psalms chapter 4, verse 3. Give ear, O Lord, unto my prayer, and attend the voice of my supplications. And in the day of my trouble, I will call upon thee, for thou wilt answer me. Psalms 86, verses 6 and 7. But let him ask in faith, nothing wavering, for he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea, driven with the wind and tossed. So if you ask God of something, don't waver. Be honest, be direct, and be faithful, and have faith. That's James chapter 1, verse 6. Thou callest in trouble, and I delivered thee. I answered thee in the secret place of thunder. I proved thee at the waters of Meribah, Selah. That's Psalms 81, verse 7. Rejoicing in hope, patient in tribulation, continuing instant in prayer. That's the book of Romans, chapter 12, verse 12. A few more. And in the morning, rising up a great while before day, he went out and departed into a solitary place, and there he prayed. That's Mark chapter 1, verse 35, speaking of our Savior Jesus Christ. And it came to pass in those days that he went out into a mountain to pray and continued all night in prayer to God. That's Luke chapter 6, verse 12, referring to our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord, I cry unto thee, make haste unto me, and give ear unto my voice when I cry unto thee. Let my prayer be set before thee as incense, and the lifting up of my hands as the evening sacrifice. That's Psalms 141, verses 1 and 2. In my last scripture, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing whereunto I sent it. Isaiah 55:11. Power in prayer, power in faith, praying, not wavering, in the word of the Lord. God bless all of you. You're blessed. And you're highly favored of God. Give your life to Jesus Christ and start walking in the blessing so that you can call on the name of the Lord and he will hear you every time.